Uses of job description. So in today's video we are going to talk about the uses of job description, how we are going to use the job description. Apart from being a basis for job evaluation, the job description can be put to many use. So we can use it as for the basis of job evaluation. What is the meaning of job evaluation? Job evaluation is a basically a process in which we evaluate a job. Okay, we get to know the value of the job or the worth of the job. So what can be the uses of job description? It can be used as supervisor and employer communication. Through job description, we can improve the communication of supervisor and employer. Suppose when a supervisor is preparing a job description for an employer, so they will be able to get the better reporting relationship, they will be able to communicate better, they will be able to communicate in a group and team. So the team dynamics between a supervisor and employer will increase, the communication level will increase, it will increase the relationship between these two, or the formal relationship between these two. And basically the when we prepare a job description, the basic feature, the reporting relationship, we know that reporting relationship is being covered in job description. So we basically establish a reporting relationship through job description. So it will going to clarify the relationship between a superior and a subordinate, okay, or we can say a supervisor and an employee. So it definitely help, it is definitely going to help in the supervisor and employee communication or relationship. Then we have recruitment, selection, transfer and promotion. So job description also helps in the recruitment, because through job description we will be able to understand that what type of skill we need in the person, job specification. Through job specification, job description, we will be able to understand that this is going to be the recruitment based, or it will be a base for the recruitment. Through recruitment, we will be getting the right candidate, and we will be able to understand the requirement for the right candidate through job description. Okay, job description is going to tell us what type of people, what type of person we are looking for, or what type of person we require for this type of job. And selection, in selection, of course, we are going to get the right candidate for right job, and this is only possible through job description. So how promotion is based on job description? See, promotion, in promotion we used to do the job enrichment, or we used to do the job rotation. So what we can do in promotion, we have to increase the duties and responsibilities, and also we have to increase the authority on autonomy, etc. So when we prepare a job description for a profile, we also define the authority, autonomy and the duties and responsibilities. Okay, so these duties and responsibilities are going to help the person to get the promotion. Okay, and in transfer, to transfer also, this is the same thing for transfer also. We are also going to say that when transfer is being done, when there is a gap of some person, or a person is not available with us, so we transfer that person to one faculty to another faculty, or from one unit to another unit. So that is also being decided, that whether we need that person or not, that is also going to be decided by the job description. Work performance appraisal. So we know performance appraisal is also based on the way the person is going to perform. Okay, and that performance, whether that performance is up to the mark or not, that is being decided by the job description. If the person is achieving each and everything which is given in the job description, that person definitely gets some performance appraisal. So that is the base of the performance appraisal also. Manpower planning and training and development. So manpower planning is basically analyzing that whether we have the resources or not in the organization, or if we don't have the resources, how much resource we need for achieving a particular target or for achieving the organizational goal. So that is also being decided by the job description. Like, we will be able to identify which areas, in which area we need to do the recruitment, in which area we need to do the selection. So that is also being defined by the job description. In training, we also define the job description as a base for the training, because training is also identified at the in the statement of job description. We also define that this person is having that, have that training or not, or whether we need to impart that training to that person or not. So that is also a base for the training. And development, development is somehow like the career path development. So when we talk about career path development, we basically doing a leadership succession program. So that is also based on the job description. We are going to impart those skills which do not, which are not present in that person. So that is also the development or career path development of that person. Then industrial relationship, as we know that in job description we also define the methods and process of doing job. So these methods and process are being defined by unions and the employees. Okay, so they should have that knowledge about the process and methods which are being taken, which are being used in the workplace. So that is also being covered by the job description. So those methods are and those process are being linked with the industrial relation. Okay, and after that we have another topic, that is organization procedure analysis. So we know that in procedural analysis is same as methods, but it is not related with the work method. It is related with the procedure of overall organization, like such as grievance procedure. It can be procedure of the decision making. It can be procedure related with the conflict management. So these are the different procedure which are also being decided at the job description. Like if you have any type of problems or if you have any type of grievance, you have to go to your manager, you have to go to your supervisor. So that is also being decided at the point of the preparation of the job description. So these are certain usage of job description. There can be different usage as well. So we have to identify what can be the what can be different uses of job description. That's all about the uses of job description. I hope the topic is clear. If you have any query and if you think that there can be different usage of job description apart from these topics, so just write in the comment. We will look at that and we will come back to you soon. Thank you so much. Keep on watching, keep on learning.